To Fashion Week.
To Fashion Week.
I know y'all are tired of seeing me in this hoodie. Trust me, I'm tired of being in it. Anyway, I just wanted to share that I just left getting my hair cut. But I wanted to share that I'm going to Paris. So yes, I'm going to Paris. This is now my fourth season going to Paris. I'm super, super excited about it. It does kind of suck though, because I have literally 3 days to pack, prep, and it's like I just got my hair cut, so my haircut's not gonna be fresh. Which I know this may not sound like a big deal, but it is a big deal to me. Like, I'm gonna be in Paris for a week, so my haircut needs to be fresh for a week. So I'm like, do I go and get touched up in 2 days? But like, that's a lot of razoring on my face. So we're just gonna have to figure it out. But nonetheless, I'm super excited to be going to Paris again for my fourth season. This is gonna be so exciting. And I'm always excited to go with Ryan. You know, Ryan is my premier client. If you don't know Ryan Destiny, she is a superstar, period. I'm super excited to be going to Paris again. And I'm taking you guys with me. There it is. I'm taking you with me. I'm gonna vlog the whole trip. I'm gonna make it a point to vlog the whole trip. I'm gonna try to vlog fittings. I'm gonna try to vlog fittings, footage from the shows, dinners, parties, everything that I can get footage of, I'm going to, and compile it and put it together on YouTube. I'm so excited. Okay, so we're going to Paris, but right now I am about to go to Ulta because I need to buy like travel size things, like little skincare, little makeup stuff. So we're gonna go to Ulta and you're coming with me. Oh my God, I'm about to get hit. You're coming with me. We're gonna get some goodies. We're going handheld. We just got to Ulta. Let's do it. Well, this Ulta is extremely picked over. I mean, when I say empty, I mean empty. So they don't have anything. Like, I mean zero of what I needed on my list. So I might have to go to Sephora. And that's really far. You know what? I could have stayed my ass at home. Cause now I'm gonna have to travel with all of my full size stuff, which is really not a big deal. I was just trying to make my life a little bit more convenient and a little bit easier. But now I'm just gonna have to travel with all of my full size. That Ulta, they might as well close that bitch down cause there's nothing in there. I'm feeling a little defeated. I'm not gonna lie. I am feeling a little defeated just because, like, I came all the way here. It took me so much to come here. Like, I have so many things to do before this trip. And, like, having to come here. Oh, let me turn my doors are locked. Having to come here and them not having what I need, it's just very frustrating. But, you know, there's bigger issues on Earth, so we'll remedy. But you know, that's the thing about New York too for me, like after spending so much time in LA and then moving back to New York, that is the issue I sometimes face with New York, is that like I have to really cherry pick everything I do. And not that I didn't do that when I lived in LA, but like it's different because I drive here, so it's like a lot of these places don't have parking. I like coming to this place because it has parking and there's like, you know, a Home Goods, a TJ Maxx, like just for me to get like those little like knickknacks and stuff, like candles and little crap like that sometimes. But then the Ulta's there, and like the last couple times I've come to this Ulta, it's always so picked over, it's always so empty. And I'm just like, girl, I don't have time for this. Like, I don't have time for this. Like, if I drive out to Long Island, then it's different. You know, I don't have to worry about that there. But like living in the city and like driving, it's like, I would do this to my life. I would make my life this complicated. Like, I would. So, whatever. I'm just gonna go home and do laundry. I'm having one of those, you know, one of those days where everything is just like not going right. That's me today. Like, I have so much to do. I leave tomorrow. I haven't had a fitting. I normally, like, when I travel, especially when I'm traveling, like, during Fashion Week, I, like, try to, like, try on all of my outfits, kind of map out the things that I'm gonna do and all of those things. So, like, I haven't had a fitting. I haven't packed a thing yet. I went to Ulta yesterday, as you guys saw. All of the travel size stuff was gone. I went to Sephora. They didn't have anything. All of the stuff that I needed was sold out. I'm just like, okay, whatever. Like, I'm just gonna carry my full size things and just deal with it. And, like, maybe it's a sign. I need to, like, I would get my nails done a week from today because I'm at the 1 week mark. But because I'm going to Paris for a week, I'm like, maybe I should just get them freshened up so they're not, like, chipped and cracked in Paris. And, like, I called Michelle this morning. That's my nail tech. I called Michelle this morning. She's off. We ain't never done that before. She's never been off on a Monday. Now all of a sudden she's off. Anyway, I mean, I know it sounds very simple, like, oh, anyone can do your nails, but I'm very particular about my nails, obviously, as you guys may see and know. So, like, that's a thing. So I'm like, I'm really not trying to put too many things off into tomorrow just because I fly tomorrow night and I want to make sure that, like, you know, everything's good. My car is parked away and, like, it's just, like, it's a lot. Not to mention I had orders to ship, so I went to go ship the orders. The post office was like a zoo for some. I've never seen the post office like this. Like, the line was out the door, and I'm like, my patience is a thing. I have zero to no patience. So, like, I'm just like, all of the things that, and then people in traffic are driving so stupid. I'm just like, all of the things that could happen are happening, and I'm trying to just be patient. I'm like, all right, let me come home and, like, do things around the house. Like, I had my friends over for dinner yesterday, so I'm like, let me get the dishes and stuff done, get the house together. I want to shave my couch and shave my bar stools because that's a whole next thing. I'm in the middle of doing laundry, so I'm like, let me just get the house stuff done, and then we'll try again tomorrow with the haircut and the nails and the shipping and all of those things. I edited my BBL cabbage video, which just went live. And I have to edit my short rib. No, it's not short ribs. They're barbecue spare ribs. Barbecue spare ribs video. So I have to get that done before I fly. Because I just don't want to have to be dealing with that with hotel Wi-Fi and stuff. And I just want to make sure I have all of my content kind of ready to go before I'm there. And you know how it is with Fashion Week. It's just like fittings, shows, parties, club. No, I'm just kidding. So, like, I just want to get as much done as possible ahead of time. But yeah, you know, this happens 3 days and we're off to Paris. You know, it's like a 3-day thing. I found out 2 days ago I leave tomorrow. So I'm just like, having 3 days to prep for an international trip is kind of silly, but it's the business, so here we go. Okay, I'm on my way to the airport. Today has been an actual disaster. I didn't know if I was gonna have a car to take me to the airport, so I didn't know if I was gonna park my car at my mom's house or if I was gonna park it at the airport. So I had to drive to my mom's house. Mind you, I found this out 2 hours ago while I was getting my nails done. So I had to rush home, finish packing my suitcase, drive out to my mom's house, which that's an hour and a half away from where I live. And now we're having to go an hour plus to the airport. And my flight is at 7:40, but you know, check-in is an hour before and it's saying we're not gonna get there until 6:20. So I'm like, I'm praying to sweet baby Jesus that this all works out. We've come this close. You know, I just feel like we have to make it. So send up a prayer for me and I'll check in with updates soon. Okay, bitch, we made it, got it checked in, got the bag in, made it on time. Now I'm trying to make it to my gate. That was so much, but God was on my side. God was on my side. This lady just wanna be in frame so bad. Like, ma'am, move. Hello.
Hi, how are you?
Good. We made it to the gate by the skin of my teeth. Hi, how are you?
How are you?
to Paris, but my KTN number wasn't on my yeah boarding pass. There you are. Sorry, I'm gonna call y'all back. Okay, so I thought my TSA pre-check expired, but it didn't. It was just like Delta's having some issue, so I wasn't able to go through pre-check just now, but we got it fixed. It's just like little things are testing me, but you can't shake my faith, okay? I got God. You can't shake me. Purr. I'm just ready to sit down, have a couple glasses of wine. I have to pee really bad right now. And just be at ease. Like, I just feel like all of these little things keep happening. But like I said, you can't shake me. Hello. We made it. On the flight. My headphones. I'll wrap my hair. I'm going to sleep, but I am really hungry, so I'm gonna eat first, then go to sleep. Get a couple glasses of wine in me too. There's a crying baby. See you in Paris. We haven't taken off yet. Someone's bag has to be removed from the plane or something. So we're still here. It's been a little over an hour. I am tired and hungry and starting to get a little irritable. But what does one do? Well, 2 hours later, we're finally taking off. And yes, I'm using the light from my phone to get some light on my face. So, I'll see you in Paris. Period. Let's go. Okay, Clementine and Pierre. Welcome, drink. Okay, we made it. We're in the hotel room. I'm staying at a new hotel in Paris called So Paris. It's very cute, it's a brand new development. So it has a view of the Eiffel Tower from the bedroom. I wonder if you can see that. I wish I could like zoom on this, but whatever. I don't even know how to work this camera yet, to be honest. So pretty. Such a cute room. And like such a great view. I'm gonna keep these open because I miss just waking up to light and just sauntering in light. So this is the room. I'm gonna do a little room tour. There go my bags, they just came up. They sent up a cute little note, which honestly I can't even read because it's backwards, but the thought was there. Cute little dessert, and that's the bed. I just had them bring up extra hangers because I'm definitely gonna need those. Cute little like coffee station. Mini bar down there. Me. Shower. It's just a cute little quaint room. I love light like this. It's always good when I'm getting my face done. Shower. And then it has a little nook and a water closet. So yeah, cute little room. All right, I ordered room service. My food just got here. You know, I'm already scheming to know me is to know. Bread and butter, especially French butter. I got a lobster linguine. Yum, yum. And of course, frites. I got frites fries. Mmm, those are good. I'm super excited. And I got a green tea because I need some form of caffeine. I only slept for an hour on my flight, so I'm running strictly off fumes right now. Y'all, I'm not gonna lie. This jet lag is whipping my behind right now. I ate, and like I was like, I'm just gonna sit in the bed and eat, like something I don't do at home. You know, I'm just gonna sit in the bed and eat. Tell me why I woke up. I'm so embarrassed. I woke up, it's pasta sauce on the bed. I'm just like, this is beneath me. I'm so embarrassed. But I have to get up because we have a fitting soon. And I just kind of want to go over the schedule and kind of know what's going on and like get super organized. So I'm going to go down to Ryan's and get it all sorted. I'm running late to my off-white fitting, but here we are. Okay, walk to me. It's fitting time. Come join us. I thought those boots would be cute. I just hope they kind of match the tone of the ensemble. Here's the denim. You want to start with the denim? Mm-hmm. I'm keeping that. Boots. Pick a wall. Boots. Damn, this jacket is heavy.
That is not the jacket.
This is definitely the jacket. No, because it didn't have this neckline.
It didn't have this ruching.
And it was cut differently.
Yeah, completely. I wouldn't have picked that if it was that. That's a whole different thing.
Say it to the camera.
That's a whole different thing.
Oh, wow.
This is not the look.
Well, we have the other look. It's given 4 or 5 seconds from wildin'. Well, this is leather.
We need to pray that that works.
Okay.
Because
we're not giving this.
Because what is this giving, though?
4 or 5 seconds from wildin'. I don't look fat, though, with the Gia boot. Mm-hmm. Where are they?
In that bag. Oh, Scot, what are we gonna do?
We need to get that taken. I'm really not the one for the funny shit.
Anyway,
we will cut all of this footage.
You need to like delete.
No.
Get
the Gia boot. Let's see the full thing. I love the boot. Let me stand away from you though, to like see you.
Yeah.
From afar. Stay over there. Show YouTube. Purr. Yeah.
That's what I was saying.
I'm recording.
Watching Love Island for the first time in my life.
Oh, my friend is the host of that.
And I get it. Oh yeah, Maya.
She's coming tomorrow. I'm actually gonna go to a Louboutin thing with her and then like turn up. I only eat healthy in pairs because it balances out the carbs and the bread.
I actually hate the hoops.
Okay.
I'm trying.
Can we have champagne? And can we go eat? I'm hungry. You just seem so thrilled about this.
I look so bare.
Oh. Fresh-faced diva.
You're giving boy.
Man. Purr. You know, what I learned about champagne is you have to tilt. Like, that's the skill, is to tilt.
Isn't that what everyone learns?
Bitch! Somebody asked you all that. Okay. To tilt. Look at that. Fuck. Fab. Okay.
Next one?
Next one. Look at the pinkies out. Oh, shit.
Oh.
It happened. It was only a little. It's just a little. Pinkies up.
Thought you
up.
Were better than this.
Pinkies up, SpongeBob.
Pinkies up.
Okay. To Fashion Week.
To Fashion Week.
Okay. We're going to dinner. Super excited. I'm so hungry.
I'm so hungry. Best cheesecake in Paris.
Oh my god.
Okay. Good morning. Today is Off-White. Found this cute puffer. Let me actually see if I can give you guys a fit check. I actually have to rush, so this is gonna be very quickly. I didn't realize how soon my car would get here. This is probably not gonna work, but my room's a mess. Puffer, button up. I really wanted to have on a black tie, and of course I forgot. I didn't have enough time, so here we are. Puffer, denim, black boot. Just super easy. I really wanted to have on a black tie. I thought a black tie would be so cool and just my little skinny glasses, my skinny Givenchy glasses, but didn't quite work out that way. So I'm running late. I'm gonna head out and vlog a little bit from the car. Thank you. Sorry. Okay. We just got here. Of course we were kind of late. It's giving 90s music video.
Yeah, like,
it's giving been around the world and I got. We're trying on additional outfits because for Isabel Marant, because we didn't really love and we need to love. Okay, she doesn't love it, but I'm kind of feeling it. So, Ryan.
It's different.
Yes.
I personally love it. She's not sold. So we're gonna try some other things on. And also love the kitty cat bob.
I might ask this if I can't get this right.
I mean, we can ask about tailoring, but.
I don't think this is it.
You don't think it's it now?
I don't think this is it.
Listen, you wanna give tits? The jeans are it. We just need a dart put in the back. Okay, our morning shows are done. I'm gonna eat some lobster pasta from bed. I'm very tired. But I wanted to do a little chat, a little one-to-one chat. Off-White was really good this morning. Thought it was a great collection, even though I had to watch from backstage. But it's so funny. So I had a seat right next to Ryan. We got there late. So her seat, someone was in her seat. It was just like a whole fiasco, and it's always the same thing in the fashion space. I feel like it's constantly like something, you know, like Fashion Week is like always exhausting, and not just exhausting for people who go to it, but like I imagine it's super exhausting for the PR team, the designers, all of the models, you know, PAs, everybody who's like working. It's an exhausting time because you're doing a lot, but like, you know, in Paris, the traffic is obscene, and we're like allotting an hour of travel time, and even that's not enough because things will happen with glam, or things will happen with, you know, whatever. Things come up all the time. You can never really predict what's gonna happen, but it's just so exhausting all the time. And I mean, we do it because we love it, but someone was in Ryan's seat, and then we found out this morning from our handler that another talent, I was gonna say the name, and I was like, you know what, no, like, let me keep it cute. But another talent confirmed that they were going to be at the show, so they ended up in my seat, and they basically had to give my seat away because another talent last minute confirmed that they would come to the show. So they ended up sitting next to Ryan, which ended up not even happening because someone else sat next to them. So it was just a whole disaster. But, you know, not too much tea. All in all, it went really well. It was like a really great show, super great trip so far. This pasta is so good. It's like linguine with lobster and like some kind of like tomato basil sauce. I feel like every time I come to Paris, like, there's two things I do. I eat a ton of carbs and I don't drink a lot of water. Which is funny because, like, at home I drink so much water. But when I come here, I'm like drinking like Coke Zero all the time, or like a lot of tea. I drink a ton of tea when I'm here, which is, I do, like, tea is fine. I drink a lot of tea when I'm at home, but like, it's to the point where I need the caffeine. So I'm drinking like 2, 3, 4 cups of tea a day just to like try to stay awake. I'm super grateful for days like this though, where I can like have a break in between, come back to the hotel and take a nap, and, you know, like, respawn for the day ahead, or the night ahead. So we're gonna do that. We're gonna relax, take it easy, rest and reset, and then come back to, oh, I love an electric Diet Coke or Coke Zero. Like, that is the way to my heart. Off-White was actually our first show of Fashion Week so far, which was really exciting. Just feels like a great way to start. We have a couple more shows coming up, and I'm excited for those two. We're doing Isabel Marant tonight. So, we still haven't decided on that look, by the way. Like, we are still trying to figure out what she's gonna wear, but she's in glam now. So I came to my room to rest and reset, and then I'll go back to hers to make a final decision. We're gonna let the hair be the judge. So we'll see. But yeah, you know, I've been having like these kind of weird feelings lately within the fashion space. It's like, I don't know if it's because I'm 30 now, or I'm like kind of like taking a step back and looking at it through a different lens, where it's not so much like I'm immersed in it, or I'm trying to like fight for something that's not fighting back for me. It's more so like I see things for what it is, and the fashion space is exhausting, but it's exhausting sometimes because people make it that way. You know, when it doesn't need to be, like, there are sometimes simple solutions, but at the same time, there are things that happen that are out of people's control. And, you know, for a long time within the fashion space, more recently though, I feel like I've felt unseen, unheard, just like kind of discarded and like put to the side. And I still hold on to a lot of those feelings, but all in all, you know, I love what I do, and I wouldn't want to stop doing what I do or have my clients suffer without me. Not that they would suffer without, well, they would suffer without me. Their images would suffer without me. But like, I love the partnership that me and my clients have created, and I don't want to step away from it because of that. I don't want to step away from it and feel like I'm giving up on it. But there are times where I feel like, where I just feel like I'm not good enough, you know? And more recently, especially being 30 now, I just feel like it's okay if I'm not good enough for the masses. It's okay if everyone doesn't love it. You know, I stand by everything I do, everything I've done, whether it's good, bad, or indifferent, whether I loved it at a point and I don't love it anymore, I still stand by it because at a time it represented where I was and what I thought was right. And where I stand today is I do feel often excluded and overlooked. You know, I always used to joke and say, oh, the forgotten girl. But I am the forgotten person sometimes. And maybe that's what it's meant to be. I feel like we're just on this, when it comes to life, we're just on this journey. And at some point, everything will make sense. Everything will reveal itself. And if it doesn't, you know, it's this whole game of life is in God's will. It's in God's hands. It's in God's timing. So I'm just here, one foot in front of the next. But yeah. That's my TED Talk. I'm gonna eat this pasta and take a nap. I'll call y'all back. Okay, I'm heading out for the night. I'm just wearing a suit. And these boots. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Okay, hi. We're on our way to Isabel Marant. Are you so excited that you wore the denim? Even though you fought me so much on it?
I'm so excited.
Tell the people how much you hate me. I'm just kidding. Don't tell them. It's all right.
I was about to give a very great explanation.
Okay, and cut. Yeah. Good morning. Oh my God, I'm so happy. Y'all know I love Nikki. Her. I'm gonna know the words to this song by the end of the day. I love the beginning of this record. Like, y'all know I'm Jamaican. This rhythm goes crazy for me. Like, my ruby the sleeves, Chinese on my sleeve. Ni hao. Who the fuck told bitches they was me now? Okay, y'all, so I probably failed to mention that I'm switching hotels halfway through this trip because one brand paid for my hotel up until today, and then another brand will pay for it up until I leave on Monday. So, this is my new hotel. It's cute and quaint. Feels very like old school Paris. Like, this is what I imagine in a storybook. Like, this courtyard with like these little shrubs and like I don't know, it just feels like very vintagey, you know. Yada, yada, yada. I ordered myself a hot tea immediately because I am feeling like crap. Like, I really do think I'm with child because, wow, I've never felt more nauseous. My stomach is doing cartwheels. Like, I have heartburn all the time. I don't know what's going on. But yeah, this hotel is very cute. Here is me. Yeah, it's just like a cute little hotel room. You know? Now, macaroons. Yeah. I'm very excited about these. This is kind of the way to my heart. I hope it's... I like the green tea ones, the strawberry ones. I think the lemon ones I love too. So I'm excited to see which ones we got. We're running late, per usual. Where are we going? Oh, wow. I'm not getting in that. We're going to Alexandra Rich. I don't know why I said that, because her name is just Alexandra Rich. Yes, we're having a romance moment today, but I'm not gonna show you yet. But Ryan, of course, fought me on the look, per usual. She fights me all the time. But I think you guys will really appreciate it. Feels very Parisian romance.
Sorry, yeah, sure. I'll leave it.
Is going away. I got food poisoning. Let me sit up. I got food poisoning. I'm losing my voice and I had a fever. Being sick in another country is top five worst experiences. Yeah. So I think I'm gonna leave Paris early because I am not well. At all. So yeah. I am in the airport lounge. It feels like the airport lounges these days are like more crowded than the actual terminals. My voice is kind of coming back. My stomach feels a little better. It's weird though, the only thing I can like keep down is Coca-Cola, which is very odd because like I don't even like regular Coke. I love a Diet Coke though. So yeah, I'm leaving. Honestly, I've never been this excited to get home. This has probably been the hardest Paris trip for me. And oh my God, why are you coughing? Ugh, I'm ready to get home. Yeah. It's time. It's really time to get the fuck up out of Paris. Oh no. This trip has been quite a thing. Hi. How are you? Okay. I'm in the car. It feels so good to be back in New York. kid you not. Oh, thank you so much. As exhausting as New York is, it is so good to be back somewhere where I can get a warm ginger ale or a ginger ale, period. Okay, I'm home. The first thing I ordered was some soup from the Jamaican spot. Not only am I starving, but also like I need to regain my voice. So, ordered some soup, but I also ordered some oxtail. I'm not gonna lie, I'm hungry. Like, I want real food. So, I'm gonna eat these. Thank you guys so much for watching the vlog, and the next one will be better, I promise. I won't get sick again. But thanks for watching, and you know, be sure to like and share and subscribe, and I can't thank you guys enough for watching.